19 bags, the lowest bag in our India. And this concept, actually, the Frugal Innovation, it was pop up from our batch, and we are going to discuss on this concept, Frugal Innovation. Actually, this concept, it can be a global model. It's a, I mean, it's a kind of an alternative to the present world scenario. So we will go on this one. Okay, this is this concept actually now, it's an image from 2019 back. Now currently we have two PhD students and a number of our MBA students. We are working on to bring this model into the operational dimension. So actually this endeavor is patronized by Dr. Dinesh and one of senior professors, Saradasana. He is a very influential one, and as well as our post coordinated solution. And this frugal, let me see what is this frugal innovation. This frugal innovation concept, the modern concept was first coined by this Carlos Gusen. He's a chairman and CEO of Renault Nissan Alliance. In 2006, he introduced this idea. The concept is to turn the business constraints into the innovative ideas and practical solutions. We just not worry about the problems, we just convert it into the business opportunities. That is the whole idea of this frugal innovation. Then, now we are going to discuss here why Frugal Innovation Hub. It's important to Sri Lanka as an Asian nation. Why it's important for us? Now here, this is Professor Saradasana. He has published a paper called Poverty Eradication Through Technology Integration Approach. And he identified that integrated technology is important to disseminate the technology into the bottom layer of the society. Instead of heavily investing on the R&D and all that. And then he introduced new framework, how we integrate this technology integration, how we will do. This is the new framework introduced by the Professor Saradasana, but unfortunately, the prevailing current corrupt and inefficient bureaucratic governments, institutional culture is the major hurdle for this, bringing this into the practical world. And this frugal innovation approach is pop up as out of the box thinking for this bureaucratic problem. So this why this frugal innovations is important, because its ability to address to the products for the BOP market, bottom of pyramid market, which mostly catered by the SMEs, and emerging new more trendy consumers. This is a new trend in the world. This is the crossing point between the modern consumers and the traditional consumers. So this consumer group is growing very fast. So this, we have the good ability to address these consumers. And the other one is the affordable luxury market, which means now we used to have this Gucci, Tempur, and this kind of a branded, very expensive watches. Now this affordable luxury market is the ability to create the substitute for these things. So the frugal innovation techniques, which we can use to develop the same quality products in a cheaper cost, so that it will cater the affordable luxury market. And that eventually, then the possibility to snowball into the macro scale. This is what exactly Nissan Renault has done. They started in a very small way, and then they grew up into the bigger scale. This is what the frugal innovation is capable of. So then, will the frugal innovation is a fit to Sri Lanka? So if it is a fit, how it fits? It fits into it's economically, socially, culturally, and administratively. We have to look at into all these angles. And what is the absorption capacity in Sri Lanka's society? So whatever we introduce, if we cannot absorb into the society, it's a useless one. And so how do we find out these things? So we'll have to go back to the history. History is always the teacher. So this is a very ancient map, and this was taken from this, so one of the author. He has researched on this one, and you will see these triangles, these old ports all around the country. You will see that 4/3 of the country is covered with the ports. So that means this is great evidence that we had an international trade. Even in the Robert Knox writing, in the 17th century, that's a popular book. So he talked about gems, pearls, elephants, ivory, tortoiseshell, and the valuable wood texts, and this all the trades we had with the world. So we have good remnants of the earlier trade civilization. And this is the most interesting one. And the technology. Now we are talking about very sophisticated global technology, but we had, I mean, as a globe, we had a very advanced civilization. Still, people cannot decode what it is in there. And you will see these, the first three pictures are, these are on Sri Lanka. And these are plateau. And this is the star constellation in the Orion belt. These all three are correlated. And this is the Angkor Wat in Cambodia. It's in this part of the world. And it's correlated to this one as well. So that means this is the, this shows us the global signature of the global civilization we had, once we had a long time before. And again, this Professor Sarathasanayake's paper, he discussed about the Sri Lanka produced world finest guns in the 16th century. So this is the depiction from one of our scholar. And this is the water technology. This is a unique to the Sri Lanka. This is called Biso water. This is you will find only in Sri Lanka. This type of technology we have in our society. And this art and craft. You will see these things, it's all among our nation and it's within our society. And this is a very good one. Actually, this is a classic example of frugal innovation which we are talking about. We found this one just next to our university. This template, this is a wooden Asian template. They use this template to use this expensive wood. Craftsmen, I mean the carpenters, they use the expensive wood. So how you utilize the wood in the most efficient way, that's how they use this template. This is another application in the textiles. They use this laser cutting and all that. It's the same thing. This is within our society. And this whole technological engineering and engineering marvels pointing towards one thing. That's a once existed great civilization which we have forgotten today. And the other thing is that great civilization, they have used data-driven management and administration system so which enable to maintain the sustainable economic and cultural and social load. Otherwise, we wouldn't be able to do the huge structures if we have a messy management system. Now, in summary, Sri Lanka is a great entrepreneurial landscape. Evidence is all around us. If you see, as a nation, we are called the pearl of Indian Ocean. That means prosperity in terms of economically, culturally, and socially. That's why we call the pearl of Indian Ocean. And the villages were given the names based on the industries. For example, Ratnapura, this is city of gems. This is a direct translation of city of gems into the Ratnapura. And there is another place called Pilimatana. So this means it's a direct translation of the metal workers, the goldsmith workers. So, and in the family clusters, we have the caste system. This is very popular in India. And these castes were given based on the industries, as well as the family names. All the family names were given based on the industry they import. These evidence are inside our society. You will see that nice hierarchical order, how it appears in our society. So that means it's in the part of the society. And based on all this information, we try to establish this Frugal Innovation Hub, which we have a clear vision. So that is an institution which trying to reinstate the long abundant economical, cultural and social ecosystem which suited to the today's context to sustainably perpetuate. And the vision, how we do this one, transforming the cost-driven culture, which is the Western model, into the shame-driven productivity culture, which is the Asian model. So this is the sustainable model. We have experienced this one. and Asia, and when you talk about this one, the Asia is the oldest civilized continent in the planet. So if you take this planet, this Asian region, South Asia, Far East, and everywhere is the oldest continent in the planet. And we trade, exchange knowledge based on the principles of collaboration and harmony instead of competition, which we are popularly talking about. And we value each other's development and prosperity. We share our knowledge and we value prosperity and development. And the lies, deception, and action against actions causing the human suffering, we reject in our pride. We sternly deal with this one. So this is the Asian culture, basically. And how frugal innovation going to associate with the Vietnam. So we invite, as a Vietnam nation, we invite you to reinvent yourself and collaborate with us so that we can bring the harmony and prosperity back into our mother planet. And this is the motto that we are going to follow. Go fast, go alone. But we choose the bottom one, go far, go together. Thank you very much. And actually now, we would like to develop a discussion on this one, and we would like the feedback from you in that so that we can develop our next model.
In fact, in our institute, we have also the innovation hub, and we have the smart hub. We call it smart hub, not startup, but smart hub. So if you can, we can join you to discuss later. But can you go back to your mission? Here.
Sorry, but same driver productivity, what does it mean?
Yeah, this is a cost driven. Now what we are,
so the same here for me is something negative.
No, this is actually the common academic jargon we use, how we differentiate the Western world with the Asian.
The literature, if you look at they talk about European and the Western culture and the Asian context, normally their behavior is driven by guilt.
Yeah.
That's why like grains and things more purchased and consumed by Europeans.
Yeah, yeah.
But in our context, normally we are driven by the shame, particular feeling. Like that's why it is something bad.
Yeah.
Therefore, I feel guilty, something feelings,
yeah,
by the emotions. That's the meaning they said. In the shame culture, therefore, we are having a different set of values. That is not something negative, but it's a shame, shyness.
Yeah, yeah.
You base your, you lose your face,
yeah,
you
yeah,
might say that.
Yes.
That's the idea you want to communicate.
Yeah, actually, now the shame culture, in shame culture, we value each other's, we value personal.
Shame-driven culture.
Shame-driven culture, actually.
Yeah, yeah, I'm worried, because you know, like when we have two choices.
If or we less like this, or we do our best to overlap, to go back.
But yes, probably just the word same driving is a little bit
too forced
for me. Okay. But okay, now we can discuss that later in the forum. I don't know your program. You will stay in Vietnam for how long?
Maybe till Thursday. Then tomorrow and day after tomorrow, sometimes we can join.
For example, I can have
some
responsive for the innovation hub for the smart hub.
SME and entrepreneurship related, innovation related, if you have a unit, then we can have a particular short discussion and have some collaborative.
You have more presentation?
No, this is the last one.
This is the last one.
Okay, so
we can do the same for the people in that unit as well, academics.
Just go and discuss them. I think now they are ready. Okay, let's go ahead.
We have some post-graduate projects as well. Then we can collaborate and do certain things.
Yeah, just discuss with the director and then we can see how we can collaborate. But
tomorrow we can visit for 1 hour, if they are available.
Yeah, just discuss with them, because I don't know, they are planning me tomorrow morning. I'm not disponible, but afternoon maybe.
Is it in the under business faculty, or you have this innovation and entrepreneurship, startup development?
Yeah, we have
under the faculty of business.
Our institution have a big network for the investor, for the talent developer.
You can meet someone from the kind of business, like even business school.
Discuss with the guy, the representative of the Innovation Hub in our.
Okay, we can meet.
Yeah, we can see now. Okay, we can see now.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.